Hello, I'm Mark Solacy, Associate Professor of Management and Director of the MBA program here at the Brad D. Smith Schools of Business within the Lewis College of Business within the Marshall University campus. I'd like to talk to you today about some new and exciting technology that's being made available through the College of Business to the entire Marshall community as a result of a very generous donation from the Hoops family. I am not a professional actor, but I play one in the classroom. In fact, any faculty member here does the same thing because it's about presence and engagement. Now, we can get that to happen when we're in the classroom. We're face-to-face with the students. We can engage, and obviously there's presence. However, as education continues to rapidly mitigate, or migrate rather, to the entire online environment, that creation of presence is increasingly more difficult to do. This technology addresses that very situation. What we have here is something known as a light board. Now, I'm going to show it to you in a few moments, but a couple of things you need to know. Not only is this the first installation of this technology anywhere on Marshall's campus, this is the first installation of this technology anywhere in the state of West Virginia. So we're quite proud. Once again, we're in the forefront. So what is the light board? Believe it or not, I'm talking to you behind a sheet of glass. It's a special piece, special sheet of glass. Now, if you were in the room here, standing where the camera's standing, what I'm about to do, you could not read because it would be reversed because you see the flip side of it. So I'm going to give you an example, just use a break-even analysis. So the first thing I'm going to do is decide what I'm going to be doing. So here we have a break-even analysis. Now, if you were in the room, you couldn't necessarily read that because it would be reversed. But you now can read it, borrowing from my, of course, my handwriting. So what is a break-even analysis? Let's do a little bit of a demonstration. So first of all, I have a y-axis, which represents dollars. So we'll go 1,000 to zero. And then the x-axis represents volume, or the number of units for product sold. Again, we'll go from zero to 1,000. So the first thing I would do in a break-even analysis is find my fixed cost. So in this case, let's call it 100. Then I would go for my fixed cost, my variable cost, continue on out. So we'll put our variable cost here. And then, of course, we start having revenue. Revenue going from $0, 0 units, and would move upward something like this. What we're looking for when we do this, of course, in a break-even analysis, is this point right here, because this point represents the amount of dollars, so in this case it may be 200, and the amount of units, so maybe here it's 150 units. The magic of this is the fact that I'm doing this live in front of a camera. I'm presenting it in a way that I can read it because I'm on this side, but more importantly, you can read it. And it's kind of neat because it looks like I'm writing in air. Now, there are other things that can be done with this technology as well. What about the faculty member who says, well, I've got a bunch of PowerPoints I want to use in an online class. I want to be able to make them more real than just having the students read them on their own. What could I do? Well, within this technology, we have the ability to simultaneously broadcast your PowerPoint. So here's the PowerPoint. Now, you know, obviously, in most cases, the students would also have access to these PowerPoints as you've had them up on the LMS. This is a standard PowerPoint, one presented by the publisher. It's made available as part of the instructor material. Now, if you're the type of individual who doesn't like necessarily to be in the camera but still wants to be able to talk through these PowerPoints, we can expand the size of the PowerPoint and we can shrink you. We can bring you all the way down into the corner and we can blow up the size of the PowerPoint. So it really does a lot to accommodate various types of teaching styles. Another feature I like about this technology is the fact that you can put a presentation up that is transparent. What do I mean by that? Well, here's a picture of something we do in my class. We're going to blow it up a little larger so you can see it. I run a simulation in my class, and in class, during a face-to-face class, we will periodically look at this output that comes out of the system, and we'll walk through it, we'll talk about it, what does everything mean. Trying to do this in an online class is very, very difficult. I know I've tried. I've tried using an iPad, I've tried using Camtasia, I've tried a number of different methods. At best, it's cumbersome and awkward to the point where I don't want to do it. Under this technology, Here's an output from that simulation, and it allows me to stand here in front of, like I was right in class, and say, well, I'm looking at the results here, folks, and I see that we have a problem with a couple of emergency loans. Now, if this was a real class that I was doing this for, we'd have the rest of the information loaded, and I'd be able to walk through various other parts of the presentation to determine exactly what was leading to those problems. So as you can see, there is a large variety of things that can be done with this technology. And frankly, I'm only just touching the tip of the iceberg. Over the last week, we have had members of the faculty and members of administration who have come in just to sort of view this, a very, very soft opening. During that time, they have walked away very impressed, thankfully, and also already coming up with other ideas. Could we do this? Could we do that? So my challenge to you today at the end of this presentation is twofold. First, I'd like you to make an appointment, come see the technology and what it can do. Then I'd like you to think, what can you do with this technology? Use it to increase presence in the classroom. Make that class more important, more relevant to the student, be it online or even in a traditional class, because you can record things and use them as reference points. Flip the classroom. Make your lectures available this way. Flip the classroom, and then when they get into the classroom, have a discussion about your lecture. So there are numerous different things you can be doing with this technology. So, in closing, on behalf of myself, the Brad D. Smith School of Business, the Lewis College of Business, the Hoops family, and Learning Glass Solutions, the vendor of this technology, I thank you for your time.